Good evening, everyone. My name is Genesis Familia, and I'm the eldest daughter of Detective Miosotis Familia, who was brutally assassinated in an ambush attack on July 5th, 2017, while working in the 46th Precinct in the Bronx. A criminal who had a deep hatred for cops walked up to her window where she sat in her police vehicle and shot her in the head while she was looking down, writing in her memo book. She was executed for no reason other than the blue NYPD uniform that she proudly wore for 12 years. I was only 20 when my mom was gunned down, and my younger twin brother and sister, Peter and Delilah, were only 12. I've been raising them on my own ever since my mom was killed. My mom was a single mother who raised the three of us on her own. It was just us four, and she took care of my elderly grandmother. The last day I ever saw my mom was on the evening of July 4th, 2017. We had celebrated the 4th of July earlier that day, and it was the best day ever. Really, it was one of the best days ever. Late that evening, just after 10 p.m., my mom came into my bedroom and gave me a hug and a kiss goodbye, just like she did before every shift. She said, "I'm going to work now. I love you." And I said, "I love you too." I looked at her and asked, "Can I have another hug?" And she said, "Yes, of course." She hugged me even tighter this time, and she gave me another kiss. Her last words to me were, "I'm leaving now. I love you." And I said, "I love you too. I'll see you tomorrow." Just 2 hours later, an NYPD highway cop was at my door. He said to me that my mom had been in an accident and that I needed to go with him to the hospital immediately. He was panicked and in distress. Little did I know that I would be faced with my worst nightmare and experience the darkest day of my life, where hell on earth would erupt for me and my family. Excuse me. I would never forget being taken into the hospital room where I saw my mom dead. I had just seen her alive. I held her hand and begged her not to leave me. I told her that I love her and that I needed her. My mom was the only person that I had. A part of me died that night, 7 years ago on July 5th. My best friend and the person who showed us what true unconditional love is was gone. Ever since that day, I've been raising my brother and sister on my very own at an age when I was barely an adult. I was just a teenager months earlier. After my mom's funeral, I adopted Peter and Delilah and became their only legal parent. I'll be taking care of them as a mom and a dad for the rest of my life. My mom was an amazing and beautiful soul who made a lasting impact on everyone who was lucky enough to meet her, even if it was for a moment. She had a beautiful smile and a cheery and sparkling personality. She was the most beautiful person inside and out, and everyone loved her. The kids and I had amazing childhoods. We went to the best schools, and my mom supported us in every way. She always joked that the umbilical cord was never cut between us because we were so attached to her. She took us to every single museum, festival, theme park, circus, and sports game in the tri-state, and even in Florida and California. My mom lived for us and made sure that we were happy. She chaperoned every school trip and never missed a school performance or a parent-teacher conference. She would always go to work right after spending the whole day with us, ready to protect and serve the Bronx community she patrolled in, and they loved her. We called her our super mom because she could do it all. One thing we loved to do as a family was go to the movies. And the last movie we ever watched with my mom was Wonder Woman. She's the heroine who is the symbol for female officers everywhere who go above and beyond every single day, serving justice and preserving peace. My mom always felt a call to serve, and she believed God put her on this earth to be a police officer. Answer the Call has been there for me and the kids at every step of the way in my journey of being a young orphan, raising my younger orphan siblings. As I dedicate my life to them and dedicate my life to honoring my mom, I remember meeting Lauren Profeta, the director, the executive director, in August 2017, at the Game and Family Day, they answered the call hosted for the fallen first responder families at Citi Field. The compassion and sincere care that I received from Lauren and her team right from our first interaction is something that I'll never forget. Lauren said to me that Answer the Call will always be here for me. Their compassion and sincere care has only grown from their end. Their support has been critical for me all these years, especially while I take care of the kids and I can't receive my mom's death benefits as an orphan child. I'm so grateful to this organization for their continued support in every way. They've also secured shadowing opportunities for Peter and Delilah through their Day in the Life program, which has been so impactful on them. Answer the Call has made a solemn vow to never forget the great heroes who have made the ultimate sacrifice and laid down their lives in the line of duty, protecting and serving our communities. They have promised to honor them by taking care of the broken families like mine that are left behind. The members of this wonderful charity have supported me, Peter and Delilah, at every turn. The wonderful board and staff at Answer the Call have always been dedicated to serving the families that are left behind, especially the children who are the most vulnerable. I'm eternally grateful to Answer the Call for being there for me and the twins, and for always answering our call for help. They honor our fallen heroes in many ways, but especially by keeping their promise to take care of the families our heroes have left behind forever. Thank you.